हेलो गाइस, आई एम गौरव वशिष्ठ। आई वर्क एट फ्यूल्ड। फ्यूल्ड इज अ फ्यूल्ड वी एट फ्यूल मेक ऑसम एप्स एंड या सो सम ऑफ द एप्स विच वी हैव वर्कड ऑन इन इन द पास्ट आर क्विज अप। आई गेस मैनी ऑफ यू गाइज हैव प्लेड क्विज अप ऑन योर एंड्रॉयड फोन। और वी हैव आई मेड आफ्टर लाइट इमेज एडिटिंग ऐप। इट्स अ कॉम्पिटिटर टू वास्को कैम, VSCO कैम एंड समथिंग लाइक दैट। एंड आई हैव वी मेक एप्स एवरी लाइक वी जनरेट एप्स एवरी मंथ। सो या एंड लाइक रिसेंटली आई वर्कड ऑन अ नेविगेशन ऐप कॉल्ड वॉल्क। सो इन द पास्ट सम ईयर्स लाइक वी हैव बीन लर्निंग। हाँ जी, हेलो। या सो या इन इन द पास्ट सम ईयर्स वी हैव लर्न्ड वेरियस लाइब्रेरीज विच मेक अवर एंड्रॉयड डेवलपमेंट फास्टर एंड ईजियर एंड लाइक हेल्प हेल्प अवर क्लाइंट्स टू लाइक मैनेज द एप्स आफ्टर वी आर डन विद देम। सो लाइक सम ऑफ द एप्स आर सम ऑफ द लाइब्रेरीज विच सम ऑफ द लाइब्रेरीज विच वी यूज आर लाइक रिएक्टिव जावा और लाइक बटर नाइफ और रेट्रोफिट एंड एंड लाइक एंड डैगर। सो लाइक टुडे आई विल बी प्रेजेंटिंग लाइक हाउ वी यूज डैगर टू मेक अवर डेवलपमेंट वर्क ईजियर। सो डैगर इज अ डिपेंडेंसी इंजेक्शन लाइब्रेरी। सो लाइक इफ वी डोंट हैव अ डिपेंडेंसी इंजेक्शन इन अवर एप्लीकेशंस सो अवर एप्स विल बी अवर कोड विल बी समथिंग लाइक दिस। सो इफ वी आर यूजिंग अ डिपेंडेंसी इन अवर क्लाइंट क्लास सो वी विल बी लाइक इफ वी डोंट हैव अ डिपेंडेंसी इंजेक्शन वी विल बी क्रिएटिंग इट्स इंस्टेंस इनसाइड दैट क्लास। सो दिस अप्रोच हैज़ वेरियस प्रॉब्लम्स लाइक वट इफ समवन एड्स अनदर कंस्ट्रक्टर पैरामीटर टू दिस डिपेंडेंसी क्लास। सो इफ इफ दैट हैपन्स यू वुड हैव टू रिफैक्टर योर क्लाइंट कोड टू एंड इट मे हैपन डैट देर मे बी वेरियस क्लाइंट क्लासेस विच आर यूजिंग दैट डिपेंडेंसी। सो द रिफैक्टरिंग वुड हैव टू बी डन इन ऑल ऑफ दोज क्लाइंट क्लासेस लाइक समथिंग लाइक दिस। और लाइक बट इफ यू वॉन्ट अ सिंगल इंस्टेंस ऑफ दैट डिपेंडेंसी क्लास इन योर ऑल योर क्लाइंट क्लासेस सो देन ऑल्सो यू वुड हैव टू रिफैक्टर यू वुड मेक सम फैक्ट्री क्लास टू इंस्टेंशिएट दैट सिंगलटन एंड देन यू वुड हैव टू रिफैक्टर ऑल योर क्लाइंट क्लासेस। सो वट वी कैन डू इज दैट इंस्टेड ऑफ द क्लाइंट क्लासेस इंस्टेंशिएटिंग दोज ऑब्जेक्ट्स लाइक दोज कैन बी गिवन फ्रॉम आउटसाइड सम लाइक फ्रॉम समवेयर एल्स। सो वेरी सिंपल डिपेंडेंसी वेरी सिंपल डेफिनेशन ऑफ डिपेंडेंसी इंजेक्शन इज लाइक इट मीन्स गिविंग एन ऑब्जेक्ट इट्स इंस्टेंस वेरिएबल एंड दिस इज वट exact dependency injection is. It's a very small definition. So like if you see Wikipedia so you can learn you can see longer definitions like this. In software engineering, dependency injection is a software design pattern which works with inversion of control for resolving dependencies. So you pass the dependencies to the client and you don't let your clients to build or find the dependency. So this is the fundamental requirement of the inversion of control pattern. So if in that previous class you had dependency injection, so like either you would have those even you could have injected them through your constructor. Or like you could have injected them through a method, okay? And like there would be some injector classes which would which would give the dependency to your client classes. Or like there are some dependency injection libraries, so which by which you use some kind of annotations which like which can do the which automates that process a little. So I gave this slide just for letting you know that there are three types of injections. One is field injection. You can inject a field, or you can inject through your constructor, or you can inject through your method. So the I have previously told the advantages of dependency injections are like the client wouldn't have to know how the dependencies are constructed. So your client and your dependency classes are decoupled. So this will always help you to like change the implementation of your dependencies. Like you can then refactor your code a lot faster. And like sometimes while you are writing testing, while you are testing your clients, so you can change the you can change the implementation of your dependency class. So this makes your testing a lot easier. So how can you use the dependency injection? So either you write the injection code yourself, you would have to write the injector classes yourself, or you can use dependency injection libraries. So some of the dependency injection libraries are like Spring. Spring is used for web app development. So like it won't be used in Android. So and one is Google Juice. So in the early years of Android development, people tried to use Google Juice in Android, but it was a very large large library, and and it used reflection a lot, and like it was very slow. And yeah, because of the large if you use it in like if you use this Google Juice now, so you will get that dreaded method limit exceeded exception. So like in 2012-2013 I used RoboJuice in my applications. So it was an implementation of Google Juice by Mike Burton and like some guys at like I don't remember their company. So it was just like Google Juice. It was a small library, but it was slow as Google Juice was. So an year or two ago, like you would have heard that Facebook did their Facebook enhanced their Messenger app, and in their comments they had written that they had used a slow dependency injection library, I know that it was this one. So like if you go to Stack Overflow or like if you see the comments on internet, if like you will see that people in the previous years people like disapproved of using dependency injection libraries because all of them were very slow. So so to tackle that problem, people came up with Dagger, the Square guys. The Square gives us, everyone knows that they give us a lot of libraries to use. So they came up with Dagger. So we we used Dagger in many applications. So Dagger was faster than the previous alternatives. So it was faster than the previous alternatives. It was easy to use. You can use the at the rate of inject and an annotations to like you can get the access to the shared instance very easily. You just write at the rate of inject in your activity or anywhere, and you can like get that shared instance without even having to make factory classes yourselves. And you can replace the modules which helped in I'll go through modules in some minutes. So like which helped you in testing the apps. So but there were some issues with the dependency with Dagger one. So like the graph composition is done when the app is running on your device. So like so like if you are doing that graph composition in your on create of application, so it took some time to your app to start up. And also another problem with that was that if you have done any errors in Dagger, in configuring Dagger, you will get to know about them only when you run the app. So like this was a like you would have to run and wait for like 2-3 minutes for the app to compile, and then you will know the error. So it was an issue. Also like there were ProGuard configuration issues. You would have to do various configuration to check what to include or what not to include. Okay, and also the generated code by Dagger one was like it was hard to understand for us, and like it used reflection, so you wouldn't know what is happening. It would be difficult. So the Google guys took this project from them. Like there are right now, if you search for Dagger, you will in the GitHub you will see one repository is by Square and one by Google. So Dagger 2 is the newer one. so it was a lot faster. It is a lot faster than the Dagger one, as the like graph composition happens at the runtime. So like there are no issues with performance, and also you will know the error while you are writing the app. So you can fix them at the time you are writing the code. Okay. Also like you won't require ProGuard configurations with Dagger 2, and also generated code is easier to understand. You can just go through their generated classes, and like you will see that it is something which you would also write yourselves. So how many of us have used like no dependency injection before? How many of us know dependency injection? Okay, like a lot of them we know. So like those who haven't used and how many of us have used Dagger? Okay, so those of you who haven't used Dagger, you will see if you it will be very easy, it will become very easy to for you to access the shared instances. You will in your activity in your activity you will write @instance and @injects and the class and in the like there's some field name, and you can get to use it, and without having to write any code for that, any factory method for that instance. So in Dagger 2 you can have application wide shared instances. Like a singleton will be the scope of a singleton can be like from the start of the active of the app and to the end of the app, or you can also have activity wide shared instances. Like if you instantiate an object in your activity, so then you can have that same instance in your fragments or any my colleagues use MVP pattern. So in their presenters they can always use their instances which they created in their activity. Also like another advantage of it is like I can mock many things while I'm testing the app. Like I can mock my JSON responses which are coming from the server, or like I can use various components, different modules to be used in different flavors. So like Dagger 2 helps me in like in these things. Yeah. Okay. So this is just. Like it simplifies access to the shared instances. Shared instances can be scoped, and like you can replace module for easier testing. So this is for simplify access to shared instances. You can write just inject this API client, inject this Foursquare API client, and then you can use these in your activities. So this was why we use Dagger 2. So now I'll be coming up with how do you write the code for Dagger. So some Dagger 2 uses annotations for everything. First and foremost, annotation is at the rate of injects. It tells Dagger to inject a dependency. So we have three kinds of injection: field injection, constructor injection, and method injections. So you c in there in your activities you can use field injection. You can so you can like as I had already told you this field injection. And besides this, you can have constructor injection, but not in your activities or your fragments or your services, because you can't access their, you shouldn't access their constructors. So you can't have constructor injection in activities, but you can have them in your different classes. Like I have made a like for example, I have made a data store which wants to use an instance of shared preferences, so I can have it in its constructor. Another one is method injection. So it's so the it is useful. It is useful for then field injection, because in the field injection, though you can't make the fields private, but with method injection you can have private fields. And yeah, another ingredient is at the rate of module. You annotate a class with at the rate of module an annotation, and that can contain methods which provides the instance the your dependencies to your clients. So it contains it's a class annotated with at the rate of module, and it contains provider methods. So as you see in the earlier slide or this slide, so you can have methods and you can annotate them with at the rate of provides, and you can have any name. The name of the method doesn't it doesn't count. You can write anything. So in now, if you have this module, and if you are in your activity or anywhere, you write at the rate of inject converter dot factory. This instance will be given to that. And it's a at the rate of singleton. So like it will have if you construct this module in your application, so this will be singleton for your whole application. And this is the component. It's an interface. So you annotate your interface with the component, and you tell it which module to use. So as you can see, you can change this module. So you can change this module, and you also write inject methods. It should be void inject, and the client classes which want to use the dependencies provided in API in your module. So there is another thing, as I had told before, you can have your singletons, you can have your shared instances for like which can last the entire application life cycle, or the activity life cycle, I've given this, I've made this diagram. So if a singleton, if an instance is for application scope, it will run for the whole application, or if it's just for the activity scope, it will be just there for that activity. Or you can have custom scopes like user session and all. So like for making a scope, you make a new annotation, and you annotate with at the rate of scope, and you can now this can be now you can have a new module which can have like in the previous one we had at the rate of singleton. So here you will have this activity scope. So if you will start this it's the if a component is initialized in the start of an activity, non-creator activity, so this activity will be there just for this instance will be there just for that activity. It will be like in the on destroy, you can you can destroy that that component. So I can do v at time. Okay. So I have a small example. Or do you want to ask questions?
Hi.
Hi.
So I just wanted to know, like, does it maintains the, like, if you make your application gone in the background from home press, mm-hmm. and then later if Android system recognizes that this was the last fragment which was there, and it just pop up that fragment. So will that inject will get, give that data? So Dagger would be able to get that object or not?
So if you have initialized your if you have initialized your component in your application, so it will be there till that application is not destroyed.
No, no.
So if
my question is not.
So if you are saying that if it comes from your task list,
yeah,
then before that your application class would be run, and
yeah,
that component will be made again. If it has gone from the if it has gone, then it won't come back.
So what would be the default values it would be holding? Like, would it store the values it has had at the last time?
Like, if it starts again, then it will run that it will run your application on create again.
So like,
and you will get a newer instance. And if you want to save that, then you would have to use
unsaved instance, right?
Your like SQLite or something for persisting the data. Then you would have to use something.
Okay.
So it won't persist your data across the application.
Okay, I don't think we have time for any more questions. So anything else we can take it offline.